In other news, college students now banking on government scholarships after the Commission on Higher Education halted its Study Now, Pay Later program. Ara Perez has a story.
College student Josh Espino dreams of becoming a cabin crew, but he is aware of the reality that along with studying, he has to work part-time as a service crew member. The joint income of his parents, both working as utility personnel, is insufficient for their daily needs. To further help in his financial needs in school, Espino applied to a number of scholarship programs.
Siyempre po mahirap. Ano po, dumating din po ako sa point na gusto ko na din pong mag-resign kasi nga po, 18 pa lang ako, parang ang hirap para sa akin. Kaya naman po, para sa pangarap.
Kung ako lang po sana eh, kasi bata pa po siya eh, gusto ko po mag-aaral kaso kapos din po kasi. Natutuwa naman ako that porsigido naman po siya.
Espino is among the students who are hopeful that they will still be able to avail of scholarship from the Commission on Higher Education amid its decision to stop assisting college students through loans. Under the Study Now, Pay Later program, students may be able to avail of a loan and pay for it when they graduate.
The Study Now, Pay Later program became Study Now, Pay Never. The repayment rate was extremely low. It was less than 10%. The government was unable to collect because after the students graduate, government is unable to go after them anymore because if they don't get jobs after they graduate, how can they pay their loans?
That's why the commission allotted 1 billion pesos under the Unified Student Financial Assistance System for tertiary education, or UNIFAST, to help students in need.
We put a 1 billion fund under UNIFAST for student financial assistance by way of loans while students are enrolled. But there were practically no takers for that type of loan. No collateral required, but they have to pay it while they are students or while they are enrolled. It is a system similar to what some of our universities like UP is implementing now. UP has a loan program where the students borrow. And if they pay it within the school year, there is no interest. Otherwise, they have to pay it before they graduate. They cannot graduate if it is not fully paid.
A students group says those who can't settle the debts should not be blamed. The group fears that more students would not be able to graduate due to the termination of the student loan program.
Siguro may problema sa job generation kung yun yung sinabi na kawalan ng trabaho sa mga fresh graduates. For nation building and for improvement ng ating education, also for economic development, dapat tinitingnan na kapag nakapag-graduate tayo ng mas marami estudyante, mas malaking investment yun. So kumbaga, mas malaki yung benefit ng isang bansa kapag mas marami tayong graduates. At in fact, hindi nga dapat pinapautang yung edukasyon sa mga estudyante. Dapat nga binibigay siya accessible yung education, pinupondohan yung edukasyon.
The group called on the government to implement additional student assistance programs and help graduates find jobs after they finish their degrees.
Kasi yung budget ngayon sa edukasyon, hindi tayo pumasok talaga sa international standard. Kasi yung budget sa education, 3.6% lang, around 3.6% ng gross domestic product.
Oo.
Na ayon sa international standard, dapat at least 6%. Kaya sobrang kulang talaga.
In March, CHED suspended accepting new applications for its merit or grade-based scholarship program for academic year 2022-2023 due to lack of funds. But the commission says there are other scholarships and subsidies available for students. Interested applicants may visit the websites of UNIFAST and of CHED for the complete list and requirements of the programs. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.